don't happen to have the requisite skill with the soldering iron to build your own computer, you could always ask someone to build it for you, in which case you might end up with something like this, which, for some odd reason, bears an uncanny resemblance to the Apple II, and actually does the same sort of job. The man who made this is Pete Perkins. Pete, it looks like it, it does the same job, you've copied it.
No.
What's the difference?
The big difference between a copy and a compatible machine is its looks.
Now, that's going to take a bit of absorbing. Let's go back to what's inside then, without getting too technical. This is your board for your Pete Perkins Apple machine.
Right.
Right? If we had the Apple board here, would we see differences?
You'd see a lot of differences, especially in this area here, as well as in the ROMs alone. In this chip, we have a saying about this. It's whatever your mind can conceive and your heart can believe, then you can achieve. That's the purpose of this chip. With this extra slot here, an individual can take this board and do practically anything he wants with it. Send telexes, run monitors, network, anything. You can't do that with a regular board.
It seems to me that you've taken the board and done pretty well what you wanted to do with it. Is it illegal what you're doing?
I don't know. I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Well, I haven't got caught at it yet.
Oh, I see. And you're doing the same thing with the IBM PC, yes?
This is a compatible computer. It does not in any way resemble the IBM PC. It has more capabilities than the IBM PC. It has 64K on, 128K on board. The PC only has 64K on board.
So you're actually claiming that your compatible non-copies are actually better than the originals?
Well, if it weren't, then we wouldn't have any reason to do it.
Unless, of course, price. Now, how much does your Apple-type computer sell for?
Probably about half the original.
Are Apple happy about this?
I wouldn't be.